Ah yes, welcome back. You're watching Aprilia Futura ABS retrofit part 2. The delivery guy was here. I enjoy opening packages with the largest tool possible, but my wife won't allow me to use an angle grinder in the kitchen. He brought, guess what, an ABS unit off of a BMW F650 GS. Just look at it. In another package there were two banjo bolts with bleed nipples, and two banjo bolts with pressure switches. Bleed nipples will be needed near the ABS unit, and pressure switches will be used to avoid hacking into stock brake light harness. They came with seals. There are two types, copper type and rubber type. I prefer copper, they are thinner but usually less tolerant to dirt. BMW ABS unit connector was virtually impossible to buy for a sane price, so I searched around a bit and found out that some cars have the same connector. The cheapest I could buy was from an old Saab. Of course, the pinout was completely different, so I had to do some homework. Write down which wire is there and which is not. Which wire I need and is there. Which wire I need and is not there. Which wire is there and I don't need. I disassembled connector and removed some wires that were there and I won't need, and put them to empty places that shouldn't be empty. No mistake should be made at this point, and making a mistake is easy, so writing things down is an important part of a job. This was not a 5-minute job, but fortunately this is not the first ABS plug I had to rewire, and it was actually quite an easy one. So the connector is back together, I double checked it and tried. Does it fit? It does. Bench testing. What it looks like a total mess is actually an ABS unit, two wheel speed sensors, an old motorcycle battery, few switches, an oscilloscope and an OBD interface that connects ABS unit to the laptop. I wired it up together and successfully got a nice square signal on the wheel speed sensor with an amplitude of 1 volt and DC component of around 10 volts. See, that's exactly what I want from both wheel speed sensors when they're installed on the bike. Getting OBD connection to work was a whole different story. But eventually, it worked, and it did really well. So a little kid inside me had to try many ferromagnetic things that were spawned by a battery drill. Some of them worked, some of them didn't. Up to now it was a lot of preparing and testing. Now it's time to work on the bike. I also replaced front brake pads while I was at it, a surprisingly easy job. I managed to fit the front ABS ring in the first episode, so the next thing to do is to fit the front wheel speed sensor. There were some 1.5mm stainless steel pieces lying around, and because I know how to saw, grind, drill, bend and do some other metal work, I've used one of these pieces to fabricate a wheel speed sensor holder. The holder must keep a sensor exactly in place. 2mm of movement in one direction and the sensor will stop working. 2mm of movement in other direction and the ABS ring will damage it. Mind you, this is an unsprung part of suspension, so there will be a lot of uneven movement with huge accelerations. Perfect air gap between a wheel speed sensor and an ABS ring. Grind down some sharp edges and it's ready to use. There it is. Looks sturdy enough, but time will tell. A little bit of on-ground testing, because things move from the bench. Here I get a nice square signal of front wheel speed sensor when I rotate the wheel. Looks perfect. However, once again, I failed to communicate with an ABS unit through OBD keyline. Still working on it. But I managed to activate an ABS pump by reading front wheel speed with both wheel speed sensors and suddenly removing the rear wheel speed sensor. I call it a success. Till next time.